All right, everybody, I'm making this video here for my business partner, Huey. This video is specifically talking about how to handle a meeting with your client when it comes to a service-based business, all right? It could be accountant, it could be an attorney, it can be, you know, specifically in this situation, it's for, you know, online marketing or social media marketing, anything where you're gonna sit down with a client and exchange visions, all right? I like to use the word exchanging visions because when you're having a meeting, the end goal is to understand your client's vision, period. Because if you don't understand their vision, if you can't get deep into their brains and pull out of that root their vision, the project will probably end in a off, not on targeted, okay? Because your goal is to try to nail the project as close as possible, like 90, better than 95%. You're trying to get the project nailed down to like 98 to 99%. And then when you deliver the project, you got that, you got micro changes to make to finalize the project, all right? Otherwise, I've had so many mentees where they're like, oh my God, I have, you know, clients that are that frustrate me and all this stuff. And this video here is to show you how to get rid of that. So when you sit down with your client, two biggest thing. Number one, I just said, is exchanging visions. And two is setting their expectation, all right? And the best advice for setting people's expectation, your client's expectation is under promise, over deliver, okay? You never want to over promise. You're almost the bad guy in the room right away. Why? Because you want to give bad news. You want to set their expectation right. And not, I'm not saying you're going to give bad news as in, oh, I'm a terrible, you know, consultant. No. The bad news is setting them straight. It's like you going to a doctor. They're going to tell you what you don't want to hear. You got to eat right. You got to lose weight. You got to do all this jazz that you don't normally do on a regular basis. So you got to do those things, right? You go to your accountant. He's going to straighten your ass out by saying, hey, you know, I can't work magic. Like, I'm not here to make your debt and your taxes disappear. Like, I'm here to do what I need to do for you. I'm pretty much a hire, pay for hire, but not in-house, right? So you're doing the same thing with your client. You're letting them know, you're finding out what their vision is, what their expectation from you is, and then you're gonna set that straight with them, being like, hey, look, I can't do these and these and these things. If you wanna look for someone like that, good luck. I wish you the best. You know, it's not realistic to say, I want a million followers overnight, or I wanna make $1 million overnight. No, you know, I had clients that expected like search engine optimization to work in 2 weeks or less. And I'm like, dude, no, it's not gonna happen. So it's best to just part ways now, save you the headache, save the refund, and all that jazz, okay? So this video is to get into a little bit in depth about how to set their expectation right. So a few examples, maybe understand their vision. It's to ask them, what are you doing this for? Is this for specifically for sales? Is this specifically for gaining followers? Is this specifically for whatever it may be? If they want to say sales, okay, great. You know, how's your sales now? What do you project yourselves? What do you want social media to do for you in sales wise? And they got to be realistic with the numbers here, because, you know, we're talking about being organic here. We're not talking about advertisement, right? Because there's a difference between advertisement and marketing. So we're talking about marketing right now, which is raising awareness, getting your word out there, delivering the value to the society, to the marketplace. So therefore, you can gain organic followers, right? Not buying followers either, right? We're talking about organic followers, okay? So you gotta let them know, number one, very important, is to let your client know. You're the expert here, so you gotta explain to them what marketing and advertisement means and whatever service that they want. You gotta break it down to them so they understand clearly what they're buying into, what they're paying you for. So in marketing, it's more of raising awareness, all right? It's not so much selling. You're not selling when you're marketing. People think marketing is like selling. No. Advertisement is selling now, because you're putting together a budget, a campaign, a budget, and then you're taking that money and you're trying to gain people, the leads. You're driving leads to the site to pull sales, and that's advertisement. So huge difference between advertisement and marketing. Always let your client know what they're getting into. So marketing and advertising, paint a picture for them. Or search engine optimization, paint a picture for them. Many people I get so many marketing calls at my business here. Hey, we're search engine optimization, we're gonna get you sales. And I look at them like, really? You're gonna get me sales from search engine optimization? I said, I highly doubt it. I don't even think they understand what search engine optimization means. I don't even think they understand the difference between marketing and advertisement mean, you know? So those are the basic core questions that you could ever break down for anybody at the end of the day, okay? Now, so then that's exchanging the vision part. Then you're setting expectation, you know, understanding that, okay, they want 1 million followers in 6 months. Probably not really doable on an organic level unless you got an amazing campaign, an amazing strategy, and an amazing product, okay? And that's sort of like it's kind of a diamond in the rough. Like, it rarely happens, but it does happen. We're not talking about that today. This video is about how to deal with your clients and set expectations so you guys have a smooth relationship. So back to setting your expectation is, you know, you're gonna have bad news. You're gonna be like, you're gonna have things you don't know. So this, the very thing that happens often is people starting this business or sitting down with a client for the first time, which is gonna be like you're trying to impress them to the point where you get the deal. I get that. But you don't want to overpromise, like, oh, I can do this, I can do that, I can do this, I can do that. And you just put so much pressure on yourself to learn all these things. You're better off to set the expectation of saying, look, I'm new, I've studied this, I know this stuff, but putting into practice is different. So are you willing to work with me? Right? People love the honesty part. If they know that you're honest and you're new and you're wanting to learn and you're using them to experiment, they're more likely to, you're more likely to set their expectation right so that they don't blow up your phone at 2 a.m. and be like, what happened to this and what happened to that, right? What happened to this campaign, what happened to that campaign, or so. It's more important to just be straightforward of, I'm getting new, I'm new to this space, I'm learning, I took courses, I understand the principles, I understand the theory, I'm here to put into practice, you know, are you willing to work with me? That's one. Never, ever overpromise anything. And even if you can, even if you are set in stone and you know how to deliver, just say, you know what, let's see how it turns out. Under promise, over deliver. So it's better to say, you know what, I'm not too sure, but I'm gonna do my best in that aspect there. Then you're going to deliver the actual results now, and they're probably gonna be more happy. They're gonna be like, wow, this guy's really impressive, right? So making sure that you don't overpromise, that's setting their expectation. Two, if they have high expectation of you, then it's probably best to have the conversation now, be like, look, anything organic or anything, you know, organic, let's just say, you know, you're not gonna gain that momentum overnight unless you wanna buy them. And you also wanna be the good guy of telling them, don't buy anything. Why? Because people will tell that you're fake. Smart people will tell that you're fake, and then you're gonna lose so much branding value, so much brand equity when it comes to that. So you don't wanna lie to them, okay? You wanna keep them honest, okay? Because a lot of people in business, they're really gonna try to make a quick buck. They're trying to just be there and just like, get it done, get it out, finish it. Like, I get it. Like, it's important to execute, but don't cheat, don't lie, don't do any of that. Keep your client honest, and they'll love you. Because I love it when my accountant keeps me honest. I love it when my attorney keeps me honest, and my doctor keeps me honest, and my friends keep me honest, and being constructive with me, and tell me to do the right thing. Because if you care about your client, you're going to give them the advice that's gonna help them in 5 to 10 years. You're not gonna wanna help them in 6 months and be like, hey, you know, most likely it's not gonna work, but you lie to them too. You know, you spoiled them, okay? You set their expectation to be like, bam, up here, 1 million fake followers, and then you got business. No, doesn't work that way, okay? So, and then at the end of the day, a little bonus here that I didn't put in, it's being professional. Now, being professional is not just wearing a suit and tie and driving a nice car and all this stuff and having an office. No, everybody thinks being professional has got to be the visuals. No, it's not any of that here, okay? Being professional is like letting them know, like me, what I like to do is I make sure me and my client has a way of communicating on a project management software, like letting them know, hey, for you and I to so you can see what I'm doing with your work, you know, just let you know where to be transparent here. Let them know what you're doing throughout the day and week and month and what your goals are. Sitting down with them, painting the picture that, hey, we're gonna do this month. We're gonna set a schedule like this, okay? Then you're gonna be able to see every day on the project management software, calendar, or Gmail, whatever it is you wanna use. You can use Gmail, you can use Asana, you can use all these different project management software there where you can say, you know, join this calendar or join this project management software, and you and I will be able to communicate on here. We can comment back because we don't have to email anymore. We can, you know, no more texting, no more emailing. That's professional. It's setting the structure for you and your client to communicate the most efficient way, okay? It's not any of the other bling blast stuff that we said about, okay? So I hope this helps you out, exchanging visions with your client, getting deep into vision conversation, setting their expectation, keeping them honest, and also third is... what do you call that? You know what I'm talking about. I hope this video helps you guys out. I'll talk to you guys later.